They came in their tens of thousands.
Bunda,
with a clear message for the U.S. President, reverse your decision declaring Jerusalem as the capital of Israel. Protesters waved Palestinian flags, and protest leaders called for a boycott of American products. It was the largest demonstration in Indonesia since Donald Trump's controversial announcement earlier this month.
I hope he will change what he's made the decision. He has to change it and give the free to the people of the Palestinians.
The peaceful protest was held at the National Monument and outside the U.S. Embassy in the capital, Jakarta. It was organized by several Muslim groups, and police estimate around 80,000 took part, while more than 20,000 soldiers and other security forces were deployed.
We are here with all our Indonesian Muslim brothers. We convey our aspiration to our brothers in Palestine. I hope that they will have their freedom and God gives them power and patience so they can get their independence just like ours.
Indonesia does not have diplomatic ties with Israel and has long been a strong supporter of Palestinian aspirations for statehood. President Joko Widodo has condemned Trump's move, calling it a violation of UN resolutions.
Leaders in Indonesia, the largest Muslim population, have joined the global condemnations of Trump's announcement, saying that it is a blow to peace efforts and risks sparking more violence.
Trump overturned decades of U.S. policy and a long-standing international consensus that the fate of Jerusalem be decided as part of the peace deal between Israel and Palestinians. The status of the city, which is important to Jews, Muslims, and Christians, is one of the core divisive issues. Which is why, for these protesters, Trump shouldn't be the one to decide its fate. Desi Arianti, Al Jazeera, Jakarta.